Hey guys, welcome to my very first YouTube video. I am Jennifer Ezepwe and here with me is the one and only Purple Imagination. Me, that was just a joke. I mean, people have their teddy bears to cuddle with at night and I'm stuck with my purple pillow. Tragic. Well, on today's video, I'm just going to be like introducing myself, you know, literally just talking about myself. I didn't want to do this whole cliche intro video that everybody does, but things did not work in my favor. First of all, I felt really sick for like a week and then I couldn't even like do the video that I wanted to actually create. I couldn't do my hair, I couldn't do my nails, I couldn't do anything, and then there was resumption. So I was under so much pressure, and this video has kind of been like the video holding me back from actually posting other videos that I actually already won't have. Do you get? So I just decided to do this whole thing today and just get it over with. So on today's video now, you know, it's going to be like the basic intro thingy, you know. Normally people actually post on their Instagram or something for people to ask them questions that they would like them to answer on YouTube, but I did not even do that. Like, I don't even have anything for this video, and that's why I'm just going to be going to my blog, you know, to actually get some questions from them. Not even questions per se. This is a post I made in 2019 when I newly opened this blog, and it's titled Meet Jen. Yeah, that's the picture I used. Can you believe it? All right, so I'm just going to like be getting my questions from here. There'll be like little changes because obviously this is 2021 and I made this post in 2019. I'm just going to get right into the video. You know, it's a pretend interview, as I said. So question one, let's meet you. Your name, age, date of birth, nationality, what you do for a living, and your religion. Well, I am Jennifer Ezepwe, as I told you before. 21 for 2 more months, I think. Yeah, I was born on the 10th of August 20. Did I say 20? Oh my gosh, I was born on the 10th of August 1999. Obviously, Jesus. I'm a Nigerian, I'm a pharmacy student and a writer, and I am a Jesus's girl. Question two, when did your blogging career start? Okay, so I started my first blog on the 14th of July 2016, which was like few days to graduation from secondary school. Yeah, I think I can remember that time because like that whole period of graduation, I think, wait, I don't even know if it was out of joblessness that I created my first blog, but I know that I've always loved writing. As a matter of fact, I had like series of diaries in my secondary school. I'm not even joking, like legitly people made it a point of duty to actually be stealing my diaries in class. So what I did was to have like 2 diaries because I noticed that people actually enjoyed reading what I had to write. So I used to keep one in my hostel, and I used to take one out with me. On a normal day, I'll take my diary everywhere I go because like something can just happen and I would just want to like sharply write about it. But because it's there still in my diary, I had to actually take caution. So I got 2 diaries, and then I used to keep one in my hostel and I used to take one to school. So I used to intentionally even be careless about it. Normally if I go out for a break, I'll see my diary lying on the floor, or maybe because like they just wanted to sharply throw it before I like enter the class back, or I'll be looking for it, you know. It was so frustrating, and so that's why I did that. So basically the one I used to take to class, I used to make sure that I actually like just be careless about it so that they can see it and read it, and it was just like really exciting for me. So a few days to graduation, I just summoned up courage to, you know, create my first blog, which wasn't the only blog I even created, because yes, after that I ran 3 more blogs, and I don't even know, they were not coming out well now and stuff, before I finally created Purple Imaginations in 2019. And hey, we are 2 years old this year, and I've never been happier. So next question. Why didn't you stop? Okay, so I was referring to the previous question I asked, because, you know, I said that I wasn't getting the result that I wanted. I ran 3 more blogs and I was getting the result that I wanted at the time. So I created Public Imaginations. Yeah. So why didn't you stop? Then my answer was, writing is something I've always enjoyed doing, and through blogging, the world can see. Deep. Next question. What are your favorite things to do? I don't even know. Do I have to read from here to know my favorite things to do? Okay, anyone that I don't agree with right now, just I won't say it. So I love writing, obviously. I love watching movies. I love singing, swimming, traveling. I love reading books by Sydney Sheldon. I'm not even joking. I love listening to songs by Taylor Swift and some other kind of artists like that. I also enjoy listening to people, and I like going on trips in my head. Hashtag imaginations. Did I have to say hashtag? Next question, please. What is the one thing you feel everyone knows about you? That would be that my favorite color is purple. And if you do not know this, are we really friends? Next question. What's that one accessory you can't go out without? That would be my earring. Was and still is my earrings. I cannot, like, I can go out with any other thing, but my earrings. I have a big nose and I have a big ear. Why would I not go out with, like, with my earrings? Why? It's very necessary, please. Next question. Where did you spend your last birthday? Okay, obviously this answer has to change, because in 2019, my last birthday, I spent it at, what did I even say? Yeah, part of it was spent on my sweet bed. Then the remaining part was spent at so said orphanage home at Ikotun. Is it Ikotun? Abi Okota? Okota. I think Okota. Yeah, but my last birthday was obviously during lockdown. So where did I really spend it? At home now. At home. I spent my last birthday at home. Next question. What other things do you do apart from writing? Okay, I'm just going to also go through this one and eliminate the ones I don't do anymore. I'm quite handy. Yup. I'm a makeup artist. I can bake. I can sew. I can make hair, wigs too. I'm also a pretty good actress. I said that about myself. Wow. I mean, people used to tell me that I'm like really dramatic, but I actually typed it. I don't know, am I really a good actress? Because I've submitted like 3 monologues to 3 different companies and they never really got back to me. Okay, the last monologue though, I think it's my email. I wasn't able to send it. I didn't even know that I never sent. So, I mean, that one, they would have accepted it because, man, I played my part well. I'm not even joking. Anyway, next question. Have you ever had your hair cut? Yep. And I looked pretty hideous, and I don't even want to talk about it. Next question. What is the first thing you notice about a person? So I was like, at that time, I don't even know about now, but let me just read what I wrote anyway. So, their eyes, especially for the guys, because like when I look at my fellow girl, all I see is another female species that is not me. Wow, that was so rude. And then Purple Imaginations asked, I said in a person, general term, not in a guy. And I was like, are guys not people too? Okay, I don't even know why I was like super aggressive around this region, but let's just go to the next question. People's first impression about you. Well, at 2019, as at 2019, I said, the masses feel I'm proud and I'm snobbish. I'm just like basically easily misunderstood on a daily basis. I don't know if I still feel that way, but I think at this point I don't really take note of all of that. Like, I don't really care. I don't care. Next question. Are you a feminist? Nope, I am not a feminist. But I have been a female for far too long not to be on my own side. And obviously the next question is, doesn't that make you a feminist? No, because if like a girl should do something evil, I will not support her just because it's a girl that did it. Do you get? So no, it doesn't. Are we clear? Good. How best do you express your emotions? By crying. By crying. Next question. Who is the one person that reminds you of the wicked stepmother in Cinderella's story? Oh boy. Okay, so apparently I had this in my diary too in secondary school. You know the diary I used to carry about? Exactly. So I had this one there because I actually wanted to, I actually wanted that person to read it. Did you guess? It was so funny. Well, if you want to get the answer to this one, go to my blog www.purpleimaginations.com and go and complete the amiibo about the person that reminds me of the wicked stepmother in Cinderella's story. Next question. What is your present challenge running your blog? Well, I don't think I have this challenge anymore, but let me just read to you what I wrote at the time. I said, this is a lifestyle blog, and so I'll be needing a nice camera to take high quality pictures that I can post from time to time. I can't always depend on the internet for things around me that I love to share. That was deep, but I don't feel that way anymore. And it's not because I've gotten the perfect nice camera, but like what I have right now is, it's just about enough for me. It's okay, and I take good pictures with it, so I'm just good. Then, can we do this some other time? And I said, sure, anytime, P. And that's how I ended my pretend interview with Purple Imaginations. So guys, we've come to the end of this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Well, if you enjoyed it or if you did not enjoy it, please still give me a thumbs up. Support a girl, you know. Also, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think about this video, and let me even know if there's any other thing you'd want me to talk about in my next video. You know, it'll just be nice. See you guys in my next video. Bye. Saying goodbye, a step by 1,000 cuts, glass box, we can meet.